So here are the things I would like to tell you. I have learned. The first thing, keep clearing your lens. Sometimes we notice that our images come out very blurry or whitish because there is some kind of dirt particles on our lenses. So before taking any pictures, you wipe your lens with a soft cloth or a tissue. The second important thing to keep in to overzoom your images because phone cameras are not meant for zooming the images. You can use 2x zoom, that is fine, but not that pixelating. The third thing to remember is don't use strong sunlight because it will make your pictures look very bright. Using a natural light is much advisable because using a natural light is more better because it will give you a natural color. Play with colors, different kind of patterns, shapes and textures. You can capture multiple colors in one image. It will make your image look more vivid. Focus on small details. Use different modes to capture photos like portrait mode, life focus mode, food mode, night mode. There are multiple modes available these days in phones. Play with different angles and perspective and different look. And never forget to do basic editing if required. So here's the first image. So when you start with, just capture some basic things which you find around you. Here is a picture from my garden. Here normal mode, get feels as well. So here's the next one. Sorry. So sunflower is one of my most favorite flowers, and I like the orange one because it's really bright, and some phones have difficulty to capture orange and red color. So here I did my focus on the details in the center of the flower. So you can see it looks more interesting. Playing with angles. This is very important because different angles will give you a different kind of look. So the first one I've taken from a side angle. In the second image, it's taken from a top angle. In the side angle, you can see the strawberries look a bit bigger, whereas on the top angle, you will notice they look very well arranged. So you can see the difference when you just change a little bit of angle. So this is a very important one for us being a local guide. We have a habit of taking pictures whenever we go out at a restaurant. Taking pictures of a dish is easy because we can take it from a top or a side angle. But when it comes to drinks, we have to take it as in a portrait form. So in the first image, you will notice there is a lot of disturbance in the background. You can see a spoon, a plate, and the person sitting on the next table. So our focus gets diverted in the background. If we move our camera a little closer, we'll see that the focus is on the main object we are trying to show, that is drink. So here is where to use the landscape view and the portrait one. The portrait is used when you want to focus on particular detail. In the first one, I used the portrait mode because I wanted to capture the expression and the eyes of the cat. She was all ready to attack a bird sitting on the tree, and I liked her expression at that time. Whereas in the second image, I've used the light focus mode, made the background blur, and I kept it as a landscape because I liked how she was sitting comfortably. Here's the power of a background image. You can easily spot the difference between the two images. The first one consists of lightings and people and a mirror behind, which is distracting the focus from the person to the background. So in the second one, I clipped it in a live focus mode and I changed the background to black and white. And you can see the difference. The image is more enhanced now. Playing with effects. This is the simple one. You can see you will have many options in your phone to take picture. So here is one is, the first one is taken in the portrait mode and the second one is black and white effect. I made it look black and white because I thought it will give it a vintage look and it looks more better in black and white. So here comes my favorite image, the lines, patterns and colors, everything in one. So here we can see vivid colors, a line and a pattern. This is just a single image, but I flipped it and made it into two images to make it more symmetrical and very interesting to watch. This is one of my favorite modes, the food mode. I feel that when we capture pictures in food mode, it makes our image look more better. As you can see the difference, the first image of the cupcake makes it look more very, very delicious, whereas the second one makes it look pale and dull. Both the images are taken in the same light at the same time in the same background, but you can easily spot the difference. The food mode is, Shreya, the food mode is just the new one, which is available these days in many phones, especially in Samsung phones.
Thank you.
It enhances the images. Welcome. So, to play colors, you go in colorful things. You can find some from your home and take colorful pictures and practice on them. So, the four images. Different, and the second one is of the vegetables. You can just take some from your home and arrange them nicely. Experiment more and do kind of editing to enhance them. So here is the basic editing I usually do. The first, whenever we see the picture taken by us, we always get a below the image so that I can edit the photos. We have the inbuilt editing tools available in every. The first one is usually to shape and crop the image, whereas the second one is for color correction. The three basic modes are available in every phone. The first one is auto level, second one is warm, and the third one is cool. These three are the basic ones available in most of the phones. I usually go with auto because it automatically makes your photo very interesting and it corrects the color on its own. If you choose the warm tone, it will make your image look. Whereas one, it's your image looks greenish and take editing is the image. You will see the difference. You will see the difference in both the images. The left one is after the editing and the right one is before the editing. So there is a little brighter image after editing, and I've also cropped a bit. The picture is not straight because I had taken it in a very crowded place and it was difficult to keep the camera stable and capture it, but I tried my best to capture it.